should be all right. There it goes. Oh, actually, that's quite spectacular at the end. And my second year, I actually think that I love boron far too much, I think, because I talk about it too much.
I
love boron. Now, I used to do lots of chemistry with boron. I kind of moved away a little bit from boron now, but I really like it.
Boron is an interesting element. It's one of the few that I've actually made myself while I was at school.
Boron sits at the top of group 13. Its atomic number is 5. So it's a metalloid. So elemental boron is a metalloid, which basically means it has some of the properties of a non-metal and some of the properties of a metal.
I mixed an oxide of boron with magnesium, heated it up, and then it's a really dramatic reaction when you add water at the end to try and destroy the magnesium boride that's formed, because you get puffs of gas coming off which burst into flames, rather like little anti-aircraft guns. But boron itself was rather disappointing. It's a sort of brown powder.
I mean, there's more of a powdery brown boron. There are several crystalline sort of types of allotropes of boron. There's one actually that's really, really hard. So the black crystalline boron is actually very, very hard. It's just below diamond on Mohs scale of hardness, so I believe. And actually, in America, there's a town called Boron. It's in California. It's got a population of about 2,000, which actually was set up around the world's biggest borax mine, which is in California.
Where it used to be transported on trains of mules, and the company that produced it used to have as their trademark a train of 20 mules sort of going along.
Of great interest to us chemists recently, well over the last sort of 50, maybe sort of 60, 70 years, have been the boron hydrides or borings. So boron hydrides are basically clusters of borons with clusters with hydrogens around them. And one of particular use and interest in the 50s was one called pentaboron, which is basically penta-5, it's got 5 borons in it. And pentaboron was investigated sort of during the Cold War, or the early part of the Cold War, as being a rocket fuel. It actually burns with a green flame. They actually called it the Green Dragon, because it burns with a very, very hot green flame, and also because it's pretty toxic, which I can actually show you if I... So I can... ish. It's probably not going to be spectacular.
And boron complexes, or borax compounds, are used in a variety of things. It's not a very expensive material. It's used in washing powder, particularly perborate, which when you heat it up turns into, in the washing machine, when the water gets to 60 degrees centigrade, it turns into hydrogen peroxide, which can then bleach the clothes. And this is why the famous washing powder is called Persil, because the per stands for perborate and the sil stands for silicate. So it's really a mixture of perborate and silicate.
Okay, so this isn't pentaboron, because pentaboron spontaneously combusts in the air. This is just benzene boronic acid. It's an organic compound with some boron in it. So hopefully we should be able to see, if I can get some onto the end of my spatula, that it should be able to burn with some sort of green flame. Hey, there it is. Okay, you can also see a bit of yellow, which is the organic bit going as well. That should be all right. There it goes. Oh, actually, that's quite spectacular at the end. Okay,